Hello, hello my lovely, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to give my Yali Beauty a little bit of a send-off, a little bit of a big farewell, because she announced that unfortunately she is quitting, or she's stopping with my Yali Beauty. She started it this summer and I'm so bummed because she has some beautiful palettes. I already did two videos with the Yaya palette, but I recently also got the Ayubia and the Jasmine palette. So I wanted to give a little bit of a send-off to the brand, creating two beautiful looks that I think are fun, they are quite wearable, and you know, totally on a crystal, but I wanted to give my Yali Beauty a little bit of a send-off. And if this is your first time here, then hi, welcome. My name is Anneke Rees, and on my channel I want to inspire you to play with color a little bit every day. I create fun, colorful looks, but I try to keep them a little bit more wearable, a little bit more presentable, so you can actually wear them every day. I mainly use high-end and indie brands on my channel, so if this is your jam, if this is totally vibing with you, then please consider subscribing. I would love to have you here. I upload at least 2 times a week, but sometimes I even throw in a bonus video as well. My Yali Beauty started this summer, I believe, in June. I checked on her Instagram. Her first like post was in June of last summer. And she went on from Blush Tribe. So she already had Blush Tribe. She quit that brand and then shortly after announced that she was starting My Yali Beauty. And she had the most beautiful palettes up. And I was like, okay, I need to get on that train. So the first one I bought is the Yaya palette. That is this one. A very stunning palette. Especially if you love greens and warm tones. This palette is stunning. I've already done 2 videos on this palette, so I will link those up here. In this video, I want to show you Ayubia and Jasmine. The only palette that is still available on her website is Jasmine. So if you want to get that palette, it's 55% off, I believe. I will link the website down below. For the first look, I will be using the Ayubia palette, which is very stunning. It's the first look and I will have a split screen. So I will tell you what shades I used on one side, and on the other side, you will see me applying the makeup. And then for the second look, I will use the Jasmine palette. That is this palette. All right, without further ado and without further yapping, let's jump into the looks. So for this look, I used the Ayubia palette. This is the look I came up with. I must say, I really love it. It's a bit more bright and a little bit more bold than I usually would do. But once again, I had a meeting just 5 minutes ago and they didn't look at me like I was going nuts. So I started out with this shade in my outer corner and I blended it in my crease, and then I deepened it up with this shade a little bit, but it did get a little bit darker, but it also got a little bit brighter. So that is something you have to keep in mind. Then I blended out my crease a little bit with this shade right here, which is really, really pink. And But I must say it suits those shades very well if you just use a very light hand. And it's a nice shade to make sure that you blend this one out a little bit more up top. Then I went into this shade with a flat brush because I wanted to have a little bit more, not that bright brightness from this shade in my outer corner. And this shade worked really nicely because it has like a deeper orangey undertone. And then I put this one all over the lid, and as you can see, it's really nicely foiled. I had to spray my brush to make this happen. And then I put this very bright pink shade in my inner corner and I brought it further over my lid just to take down that very orangey shade, orangey color from this shade. And I think they match really well, even though this is really like a cool tone pink and this is more of a orangey red. And then for my lower lash line, I used this shade to create a bit of a lower lash line. I didn't want to use any of the brighter shades because I don't want to have the look too bright and too bam bam bam. So that is what I did, and I think it looked really cute. It is very spring, it is very nice, and I am really glad that I picked this baby up before my Yali is totally shut down. So if you can still find it, I would highly suggest that you get it because it is such a great spring palette. So for this look, I wanted to do a multicolored crease because I was watching Annette's makeup corner the other day and she was doing the same thing. I never do that, but she was like, I always do this, it's so annoying, but I never do it, and I thought this would be fun, and I really wanted to combine this beautiful yellow and this beautiful purple together, so that is what I did. I started off with this color, which is a Satoon. And I started it in my inner crease, and I dragged it a little bit further than halfway, and then I took that beautiful purple shade Nadia, this one, and I started off like not in my outer corner but in the outer part of my crease. And I tried not to make it too bold, but in the beginning I went a little bit overboard, but you know, it's always fixable. Then I took No Sheen because I wanted to see if I can deepen up the outer corner. Didn't really deepen it up, but what it did, it gave it a little bit more dimension and a little bit more, I don't know, base to build on later. You will see later. Then I wanted to play with these purple shimmers, and I took my Yali, and of course I wanted to, you know, use my Yali because that is the name of the brand. And I put that all over my lid. The thing though with this type of shade is that I will show you, for me, on my eyes, it's like it has this purpley red pinky base, and on my eyes somehow that doesn't flatter me at all. It makes me look I have been crying, so I didn't want to do that. So what I did, I took Munasa, I'm so sorry if I'm mispronouncing these names, but I took Munasa, and this has a very beautiful, I hope I can show you, this has a very beautiful pinky and purple shift. So what I did, I put this in my inner corner, and then I dragged it over that Mayali shade a little bit, and I think that looked so beautiful because it kept my outer corner a little bit darker, but it made my inner corner and the inner part of my lid so much lighter and less of that base that I don't think is flattering on me. And then I took Nadia again, and I put it in my on my lower lash line together with Satoon, this one, Satoon, a little bit in the inner part of my lower lash line. And then I just took Munasa and I put it in my inner corner. And I think, yeah, this is not necessarily a look I would wear to work. So to say that it's wearable for work or presentable for work, no. But this is a look I would totally wear outside. I will have to do some grocery shopping in a minute. I will just happily do that, or go out for drinks if we can in a look like this. I think it is really cute. Just to make sure I didn't went too far out and made this too bold of a look, I used the sponge that I applied my concealer with, and I just took it up a little bit. So you have a little bit of that concealer covering up the outside of the look. And I always do that. I have a video on some hacks that I use that are easy if you want to enhance your makeup a little bit. I will put it up in the cards. That is what I did. Okay, ladies, that is it for me for today. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for helping me, giving my Yali a little bit of a send-off farewell. I really wanted to shout out the brand a little bit more because I am so sad she's quitting. I'm just sad about it. She must have her reasons. It must be a very good reason, but I'm still a little bit bummed because I think the palettes I've showed you and of course the Yaya palette are so stunning. Once again, thank you so much for watching. I hope you loved what you saw. If you did, then please give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, because I would love to see you in my next one. Bye!